call from the dark. Yeah, we've been delivered. So we sing and we dance, and we worship together, with your name lifted high, forever and ever. Nothing's gonna hold it, nothing's gonna hold it down. No, no, I said nothing's gonna stop it, nothing's gonna stop it now. 'Cause this is
to see you again. Welcome back to day two of Bolt Totally 80s. My name is Casey and I'm your hostess with the mostess. Today, we're going to continue our tubular trip through the early church. Before we get started though, I need to teach you our 80s word of the day. The word is dude.
Dude! The word dude can have 100 different meanings depending on how you say it. For example, you could say, dude, you got mad air on that skateboard. Or you could say, dude, you just broke my Optimus Prime. Or you could say, dude, if we go on that ride, you better not get sick on me. There's almost no limit to the number of ways you can use the word dude.
So dudes, let's see how many ways we can use it today. To get us started, I have a challenge for you. In 1984, Transformers were the number one selling toy in the whole world. So, here's my challenge. Take a look at this robot and see if you can guess what it transforms into before it's finished. Shout it out when you think you know what it is. T-Rex! Today, we're going to learn that if you love and follow Jesus, you too can be a transformer. Now, you might not turn into a T-Rex, but Jesus can transform you into something pretty awesome. We're going to find out what it is in just a little bit. But first, I think we should play some games. So, come on dudes, let's bolt!
Hello, everybody, and welcome to BSTN, Bolt Sports Television Network. My name is David Roush, and this is my co-dude, Tim... What in the world? Woodrome. Tim, we're on live television right now. Why are you wearing that mask?
It's not a mask, David. I'm a real-life robot now. I've actually transformed into Optimus Prime, the leader of the Autobots.
That's weird, Tim, because only your head has changed.
Well, David, I guess it's a slow transformation.
Interesting as always. And a big welcome to all of you viewers at home. Thanks for joining us for today's broadcast of a new sport that is transforming the world. A sport called More Than Meets the Eye.
That's right, David. More Than Meets the Eye is the quick-changing game that requires athletes to take the form of various animals and objects. And joining me now to talk about what it takes to become the Titan of Transformation, my fellow Autobot, Bumblebee.
Oh, wait. Seriously? You got an interview with a real-life Transformer? Not just some silly guy in a costume?
I give you my word, David. There is no costume involved. Now, if I may, Bumblebee, thanks for joining us. Can you tell the viewers at home what it takes to win at this sport?
Are you kidding me? That's not Bumblebee. That's a bumblebee. And they don't talk.
Wow, David. That really stings.
It does indeed, Tim. Well, it looks like today's match is about to begin. Let's go down to the field where Casey is going to explain how the competition works.
All right, athletes, you know how this game works. We are playing Transformers. You're gonna make your way from one end of the field to the other in whatever way I tell you to transform. It may be an animal, it may be an object, but you have to get from one end to the other as that animal or object. Do you understand the rules?
Yes, ma'am! Yes,
all right, let's do it. All right, Transformers, transform into a robot. One, two, three, let's roll. All right, Transformers, transform into a crab. Three, two, one, let's roll! All right, Transformers, transform into a kangaroo. One, two, three, let's roll! All right, Transformers, transform into a baby. In three, two, one, let's roll! All right, Transformers, transform into a horse. Three, two, one, let's roll! All right, Transformers, your transformation is complete!
That was truly a transforming experience. And now, for those of you watching at home, it's your turn to play.
That's right, Tim. When I say so, press pause on the video. Then go play More Than Meets the Eye for yourselves. When you're finished, though, don't rest just yet, because there are even more games for you to play. When all the games are finished, grab a snack, open your Bibles to the verses on the screen, and read them together. After that, press play again and join us in progress. Are you ready? It's time to bolt. In three, two, one, press pause.
Famous 80s dance move is this? Is it the running man? The moonwalk? The snake? Or the Roger Rabbit? It's the moonwalk. Did you get it? All right, next question. In 1986, the Bangles, an all-girl rock band, released the hit song, Walk Like What? A magician? A Christian? A physician? Or an Egyptian? It's Walk Like an Egyptian. Did you get it? All right, next question. In the hit TV show Small Wonder, the Lawson family claimed to have an adopted daughter named Vicky, but Vicky was actually a what? An alien? A robot? A doll who came to life? Or a mermaid? She was a robot. Did you get it? All right, next question. Today, the average movie ticket costs over $9. What was the price in 1985? 235, 355, 525, or 805. Can you believe it was only $3.55? Did you get it? Well, I'll see you next time.
Welcome back, dudes! Those games were so rad. And I'm glad you got to experience what it's like to be a Transformer. Hey, you know what? That actually reminds me of today's Bible story. You see, way before Optimus Prime and Bumblebee, there was a Transformer named Saul. He didn't turn into a big rig or a race car. He actually turned into something way more tubular. In the Bible, in the book of Acts, the early church kept growing bigger and bigger. More and more people were hearing the good news of Jesus and becoming Christians. But not everyone. In Jerusalem, there was a man named Saul who hated the Christians so much that he would do anything to get rid of them. Saul would look everywhere for Christians, and whenever he found one, he would grab them, arrest them, and drag them off to jail. Saul even wanted to have the Christians put to death. He was one bad dude. One day, Saul was walking with his friends on the road toward the city of Damascus when something crazy happened. As he was walking, a super bright light from heaven flashed all around him. Saul fell to the ground. Then he heard a voice say to him, "Saul, Saul, why are you going against me?" Saul replied, "Who are you, Lord?" The voice spoke again, "I am Jesus. Now, get up and go into the city where you will be told what to do." Saul got up from the ground like the voice told him, but when he opened his eyes, he couldn't see. For the next 3 days, Saul was totally blind. So his friends led him by the hand to the city of Damascus. In Damascus, there was a Christian named Ananias. One night, Jesus called out to Ananias in a vision and told him to go find Saul. But Ananias said, "Lord, I've heard stories about Saul. He's one bad dude. And people say he's hurting your followers. And now he's come here to arrest us." But Jesus told Ananias not to worry. "Go," Jesus said. "I have chosen Saul to work for me. He will make my name known to the people of Israel and the whole world." So Ananias went to the house where Saul was staying. He placed his hands on Saul and said, "Brother Saul, you saw the Lord Jesus on the road as you were coming here. He has sent me so you will be able to see again and be filled with the Holy Spirit." Right at that moment, something like scales fell from Saul's eyes, and he could see again. Saul, who once hunted for Christians, stood up and was immediately baptized to show that he too was now a follower of Jesus.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to The Fold. We're glad to see you for today's coverage of professional indoor origami. My name is David Rausch, and I'm joined by my co-anchor, Tim Woodrum. Tim, professional indoor origami has exploded in popularity. What do you think it's like for today's origami athletes to perform in front of a stadium full of fans?
Well, David, some of the athletes fold under the pressure, while others can really fold under the pressure. You know what I mean?
I'm not sure that I do, Tim. Now, viewers at home, remember that you too can participate in the origami action. For today's event, you'll only need nimble fingers and a square piece of paper. The paper can be any color, including white. And if at any time you need to pause or rewind the video, including right now, don't hesitate to do so.
Well, David, our origami athlete looks like she's smoldering for some foldering. Let's go now to ringside for the start of this paper caper.
Once again, we join Tina Folderina from West Medina. I'm told that she'll be transforming this orange piece of paper into a pair of shades.
David, can you imagine what an honor this must be for that piece of paper? While his friends are sitting in a Xerox machine, Orangey McPaperface is sitting center stage, about to be folded by the world-famous Tina Folderina.
Really, Tim? Orangey McPaperface? Tina steps onto the court and immediately flips the paper over.
Oh, look at that! Orangey McPaperface almost got away from her. A rare stumble by Tina.
Good recovery, though. She folds the paper from corner to corner, and she works that crease down nice and flat. She turns the paper around and makes a small corner fold. Then she unfolds that bottom half.
Oh boy, would you look at that move! This is classic Folderina.
You are right, Tim. This is the move that won her the gold medal in the 84 Olympics, where she narrowly defeated Hans Andersen of Germany. It's called the quintuple roll-de-foldy. It's five long, narrow folds, almost as if she's rolling the paper.
Here comes roll number three. Roll number four. She's one fold away from tying her record for number of roll-de-foldies. Is she going to do it? Yes! She did it! A quintuple roll-de-foldy!
Wait! Wait, did I just see that? She rolled it a sixth time! Holy moly, roll-de-foldy! You saw it here, folks! Tina Folderina sets a new world record with six roll-de-foldies. And she's not even done. She flips the paper over, folds the corner up.
I'll tell you, David, I am dizzy with excitement.
Folderina folds one arm down, then back up again. She folds the other arm down. Then back up.
And would you look at that? Orangey McPaperface has been transformed into a totally rad pair of shades.
Oh my, Mr. and Mrs. McPaperface must be proud of their boy. And there you have it, folks. We witnessed history in the making today. Join us again tomorrow for another masterful performance by the origami superstar, Tina Folderina. And once again, happy folding, friends.
Isn't that incredible? Saul was like the original Transformer. He had been one of the baddest dudes ever. But then he had a blinding experience with Jesus on the road to Damascus and was transformed into a new creation. Now, instead of arresting and killing Christians, Saul became a Christian. And when Saul became a Christian, everything changed, even his name. Later on, Saul would become known as Paul. And instead of squashing the good news about Jesus, Paul shared the good news with everyone. Instead of trying to destroy the church, Paul started a whole bunch of new churches. Instead of discouraging people from following Jesus, Paul encouraged the new believers. In fact, out of the 27 books in the New Testament, 13 of them are letters from Paul encouraging others to live and love like Jesus. It's like the old Saul was gone and a new Saul showed up. In fact, that's what he said in his second letter to the Corinthians. It's in the Bible. I think we should check it out together. Oh, there's just one thing. We've got to get to it first. So come on, stand up and let's go.
Shall we play a game? Run, jump, duck, and spin with our hero. Whatever he does, you do it too. Are you ready, player one?
Nice job! You made it! Now, read this with me. When anyone lives in Christ, the new creation has come. The old is gone, the new is here. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Nice job! Let's do it again, but this time, some of the words are going to disappear. Say it with me again. When anyone lives in Christ, the new creation has come. The old is gone. The new is here. 2 Corinthians 5:17. That was really good. Let's do it again, but this time, more of the words are going to disappear. And you're going to say it without me. Are you ready? Go ahead and say it. Let's do it one more time, but this time, all of the words are going to disappear. Are you ready? Say it one last time. Nice job! Way to go! When we become Christians and start following Jesus, we become a new creation. It's like our old self dies on the cross with Jesus and we're transformed. Not into a big rig or a T-Rex, but into a new person who wants to do what is right. The old us is gone and the new us is here. Instead of hating, we have a desire for love. Instead of fighting, we have a desire for peace. Instead of doing whatever we want, we have a desire for self-control. And even though we still mess up and sin, we feel sorry and have a desire to be forgiven. And you know what? That makes me think of a question. After I ask the question, I want you to pause the video and talk about it with the people around you. When you're finished, you can press play again. Okay, here's my question. How has Jesus made you a new creation? In other words, how do you act or think differently because of Jesus? Press pause and discuss. When you have Jesus in your life, you become more than meets the eye. You might look the same on the outside, but inside, you have been transformed. You are a new creation with a new heart that loves and follows God. So, Transformers, let's roll into following Jesus. Well, dudes, that's it for today, but there's still so much more to come. Do you want to see a preview of tomorrow's game? Okay. Watch close, because it's going to happen fast.
Me!
They got you!
I told you it was going to be fast. If you want to see the rest of the game and play it for yourself, join me tomorrow so we can bolt into action again. In the meantime, thanks for joining us. Bye, everybody!